people, fourth largest.
Fourth highest all time since 2018, so very appreciative of that. It was a special environment. You talk about the stats that we track, I think, you know, tell the story. We won the field position battle. We won the penalty battle, which to me, obviously, is a real good sign of a disciplined football team. We only had one penalty for 5 yards. We won that battle. The turnover battle was a tie, fairly unusual. Neither team turned the ball over in the opening game. On that note, you know, I think that that's a good quarterback. That quarterback is going to cause problems for people this year. He is mobile. He can extend plays. He's accurate. But that was a positive. And then explosive plays, you know, we won that. We were 15%. So those things kind of tell the story in my mind. It was great that we were able to get 7 first-time starters on the field. You know, you talk about, you know, Drew Allar is the first quarterback to throw for 300 yards in the season opener since 2014. And then if you talk about 325 yards, second most by a quarterback in his first start. So a lot of really good things there. Awesome to see so many Lettermen that we had back. Ton of Lettermen. This obviously game is before the NFL season gets started, so a lot of the guys were able to come back. It was great to see all those guys. And then at the end of the game there, getting our 2s and 3s in there on defense. Obviously, you hate to give up a score, but the fact that those guys were able to get that playing time, I think is really valuable. We discussed that as a staff, wanted to do a better job of that, of getting those guys on the field. They were able to do that. Now we're going to be able to coach those guys and correct from it. You prefer not to give up that score, though, late. And then to be able to get the second offense in there, and the backup quarterback in there, and for them to be able to move the ball down the field and get a score was big. So a lot to build on, a lot to correct. I thought we were inconsistent really in all 3 phases. We've got to get those things cleaned up. But we'll enjoy it tonight. Tomorrow we'll get to work on this film and making the corrections and then get started on Delaware. So appreciate everybody being out and open up the questions.
Thank you. Thank you.
Hey, James, on this side.
Hey, Mark.
Hey, how's it going? Could you assess a little bit further the job that Drew did, specifically when it came to facing some of the pressure that got to him and the decision-making overall that he made in his first start? Thanks.
Yeah, you know, if you look at him, if these statistics, you know, are right here, you know, Drew was 21 of 29 for 325 yards and 3 touchdowns. Obviously something, you know, really good to build on and no turnovers. You know, like I talked to you guys about last week, you know, I thought the one ball should have been a turnover. So just like I was talking to you about from practice, we'll grade that as a interception decision or interception throw. So we were fortunate. You know, to me, you're going to make that throw in the red zone. You want to put it up high where our guy's going to catch it in the back of the end zone. Nobody does. But besides that, I thought he did a really good job of managing the game from a decision-making standpoint. He's extremely poised. Like we've talked about in the past, he's mobile for a big guy, does a great job of climbing the pocket, keeping his eyes up. So I was very pleased. And then on top of that, we were able to spread the ball around, I think, if I'm correct here, the 9 different receivers, if I'm correct there. So that's a positive as well, that he was able to get a ton of guys involved in the game and have an impact.
James, to your left. The defense, how do you think your defensive front played against their offensive line, and what did you do differently defensively? Why were you effective more in the second half?
I think the biggest thing in the second half is we were able to get off the field on either third or fourth down. I think they got a good offensive line. They were touting their offensive line coming into the season. And I think their offensive line is great. I think the quarterback does a phenomenal job. When you are rushing that type of quarterback, you got to keep in your rush lanes. You can't get above the level of the quarterback. And that causes problems tonight. But I think it's going to be good for us in the long term, that type of mobility at the quarterback position. And they were smart.
James, how would you, if you do right, James, how would you evaluate how Keandre and Trey played, and what's your confidence level in the receivers behind them after seeing the full game?
Yeah, no different than what you guys kind of keep asking me. You know, like we said, we feel like Keandre and Trey, you look at it, one has, you know, 7 catches and one has 4 catches, one for 72 yards and one for 123 yards and 2 touchdowns. Feel like we got those 2 guys that have kind of established themselves. And then we got a group. We saw, you know, McLean do some good things today. You saw Liam Clifford do some good things today. I think we got other guys that can as well. We saw Dante Zepas do some things. So obviously, I think we had 2 drops down there in the red zone that both were went for touchdowns. So we got to get those things cleaned up. But there's a group of guys that we feel good about, but we just need to be more consistent.
Okay. How close was the team competition during certain camps for practice and sort of part of that too? And then what did you decide to make a change? Was it just misses, or were you going to split it in half based on what, you know, played out? And then what is your plan moving forward at this point?
Well, we do 3 questions? Yeah, I can't tell you my plan moving forward. Obviously, we made a change during the game. We'll discuss it. There'll be competition all year long at every position. But we have the depth that if it's not a guy's night, we have somebody else that we can put in at really every position. But we obviously have not made any decisions. We haven't met as a staff. We haven't watched film. We haven't had a week of competition. So no decision.
Anything that he did, the throws that he made, the way he handled himself with that pressure on the run, did any of that surprise you, or is that the Drew that you saw in preseason camp?
No, that's the Drew that we saw in preseason camp. You know, I think that's, to be honest with you, that's the Drew we saw in limited reps last year in terms of when he got in the game. He did some really good things. He just feels very poised and confident. You know, the other thing I would say, because I think somebody else asked this question, to your point, you know, they were smart. They played a ton of cover 0, which if you're going to play a young quarterback and you play cover 0, which allows you to get more guys in the box that we can block in the run game or in protection, and create a pressure situation for a quarterback, that's a smart plan for a first-time start. But Drew was able to execute cover 0 plan, and except for one, we had the slant to Keandre that he got pressured, he was losing ground, he kind of threw it low and slightly behind him. If that thing's out in front, Keandre walks in from 70 or 60 or whatever that was. You know, besides that, I thought he managed it really well. Bo did the same thing. We were trying to run to get the ball at the end of the game there. Again, you're going to go cover 0. You're forcing us to throw the ball. Bo checked to our cover 0 plan and picked up a first down there. I think it was on third or fourth down. So, you know, I'm proud of both of those guys.
You mentioned earlier this week that there were some things we just couldn't see in practice, like Bo's mobility and like the special teams performance. After seeing some game time from obviously Bo and the special teams, how do you feel on those things now?
Bo from special teams?
I mean, on Bo's mobility, we can't see in practice, and then how special teams separately, how they perform in game versus practice.
Gotcha. So special teams, I thought we were inconsistent. Obviously, we missed the 2 field goals. Kickoff, we were fortunate. We kind of squibbed one and could have went out of bounds on us. We were fortunate. it's going to be a different style. He's still able to throw the ball and be successful. We didn't ask him to do that in this game based on, you know, what the school was and where the ball was. But there's some things that are going to show up in Bo's game that I think is going to help us this year.
Last question to Andrew.
Coach, back to the camera. West Virginia threw a lot of different things at you, a lot of different books, different plays, and all of that jazz. How did you feel you guys responded, and what kind of about that gotcha moment that you guys had gotten at?
Yeah, those things are important, right? In over the games, you're going to get some of that stuff. We were preparing for, I think we got a little bit fortunate on the double reverse pass because I don't think the receiver got the call. He was blocking. He was the only receiver on that play. The quarterback was looking, so I think it would be interesting to see how that would have played out. At least that's how it looked for me. I had to watch the tape, but that's how it looked for me. But, yeah, I thought for the most part our guys handled it. You just never truly know what you're going to get in an open game. Are they going to be similar?